Hi, I'm Torben Janssen. Welcome to this in-depth guide on how to change an entity attribute with Hibernate before inserting or updating it in your database. In a comment on my blog, Mehmet asked how he could call a function before inserting or updating an entity in the database. There are several ways you can call a function as part of an SQL insert or update statement. But these are not your only options. To change an attribute's value before the statement gets executed, you can add code to the setter method, implement a lifecycle callback, define a Hibernate-specific column transformer, or provide custom SQL insert and update statements. Before taking a look at all four of these options, be sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon to get new videos every week. On this channel, I will show you how to create your entity mappings with ease, building incredible efficient persistence layers with Hibernate and Spring, and all types of other Java persistence-related stuff. And also don't forget to like this video if you found it helpful. By doing so, you are helping me to reach more people with it. Let's go to the IDE to take a detailed look at the four options. By far the easiest approach to adapt the value of an attribute before it gets persisted is to add the required code to the setter method. I use this in the following code snippet to trim leading and trailing white spaces when setting the description attribute. This approach's advantage is that it doesn't require any external trigger to trim the description string. But it also has the disadvantage that you execute this operation every time the setter method gets called. To prevent Hibernate from triggering this operation every time it gets an entity from the database, you should annotate your primary key attribute with the ID annotation. This tells Hibernate to use field-based access for this entity. It will then use reflection to set the entity attributes instead of the getter methods. As I explained in a previous article in my blog, each entity object has a lifecycle. Depending on the operation performed, the object changes its lifecycle state. You can implement lifecycle callbacks that Hibernate triggers when an entity changes its lifecycle state. Suppose you want to trigger an operation before Hibernate executes an SQL insert or update statement for a specific entity class. In that case, you can add a custom method to that class and annotate it with pre-persist and pre-update. This tells Hibernate to call that method after you called the entity manager persist method and before executing the SQL update statement. Within this method, you can only perform operations on that entity object. This might be a limitation in some situations, but it's more than good enough to implement a validation or change a value before it gets persisted. As you can see, I annotated the remove whitespace method with pre-persist and pre-update. It contains the same code as I added to the setter method in the previous section. Please keep in mind that the code in your lifecycle callback doesn't get called until you persist a new entity or Hibernate executes the SQL update statement. In the example, that means my business code can't expect that the string in the description attribute has been trimmed. It needs to be able to handle trimmed and untrimmed descriptions. To trigger a database function instead of implementing it in your Java code, you can use a column transformer. It enables you to define a native SQL snippet used for all write operations. You can also provide one for each read operation. In this video's example, you could call the database function trim to remove leading and trailing white spaces from the description while writing it to the database. And because there is no need for any adjustments during read operations, you don't need to specify the read attribute of the column transformer annotation. This is very similar to the formula annotation which Mehmet mentioned in his question. This approach's main advantage is that you provide a native SQL snippet that Hibernate embeds in all write operations. That enables you to use all features supported by your database and doesn't limit you to Hibernate's feature set. But if you deploy your application using multiple DBMS, you also need to make sure that all of them support the database function. And the fourth option is to define custom SQL insert and update statements for the entity class. This approach is similar to the one I described in my video about implementing a soft delete with Hibernate. I will add the link to it in the description and you should have a look at it. Hibernate's SQL insert and SQL update statements enable you to define the native SQL statement used to persist and update an entity. You can use them to call a database function that changes the value of an entity attribute while persisting it in the database. This approach is similar to the previously described column transformer. In both cases, you are adjusting the SQL statement that inserts or updates the database records. But providing your own insert and update statements for an entity class is more complex than only providing the SQL snippet used for a specific attribute. Because of that, I prefer a column transformer over a customized insert and update statement. You have multiple options to adapt the value of an entity attribute before persisting it in the database. The easiest one is to add the required code to the setter method of your entity class. If you use field-based access and make sure that you don't call this method multiple times within the same use case, this approach doesn't have any side effects. Because of that, this is my preferred approach to adapt the value of an entity attribute. A lifecycle callback is your second best option to change an entity attribute before persisting it. You can tell Hibernate to trigger it when you persist a new entity object and before it executes the SQL update statement. But please keep in mind that Hibernate tries to delay an update statement's execution as long as possible. Because of that, your business logic needs to be able to handle values that haven't been adjusted by the lifecycle callback. If you can't easily implement the required operations in your Java code, you can use a database function instead. The best way to do that is to use a column transformer. It defines a native SQL snippet that Hibernate embeds in each SQL insert and update statement. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free member library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content like cheat sheets and ebooks about JPA and Hibernate. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!